number 18. The fourth fight of the afternoon on our prelims. A light welterweight contest consisting of 3 3-minute rounds. Your referee for this contest, Mr. Paul Crossley. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome one more time, fighting out of the blue corner, representing Lion's Den. He has an amateur MMA record of 1 win and no losses. Please welcome Fouad Mildor. And his opponent in the red corner, representing Intensity MMA, ladies and gentlemen, Aaron Bolton.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, cage door set to close on this light welterweight contest at 165 pounds. Aaron Bolton fighting out of the red corner, the long black shorts, as he takes on Lion Den MMA's Fouad Mildor. The black shorts, trimmed with red, and throwing heavy and hard is Fouad Mildor.
Yeah, very
and
explosive stuff from Mildor.
He don't want to get paid for the hour, but he's got to be careful as he walks into that takedown from the Intensity man, Aaron Bolton.
Yeah, nice job there, though, pushing down on the head and getting back to the feet. But yeah, he exploded out of the blocks there and throwing heavy shots. And I like what Aaron Bolton's doing here, just trying to close the distance and just calm things down a little bit.
Slow down the aggressiveness of Fouad Mildor there. And Dave Matthews and the Lion's Den team in the corner. And
yeah, beautiful work. They just used the momentum there of Mildor, who's pressing forward with that four-shot combination, just angled off and got the takedown beautifully.
Went straight into the level change, sitting down and got that half, sitting in the half guard at the moment. There's the quarter guard, not half guard. Fouad Mildor thought was looking maybe for a Kimura grip there.
Yeah, I think. Let's go. That very difficult submission to pull off the Kimura. You have to be extremely strong.
Well, that's the one. I mean, look at the build on Fouad Mildor, and the one thing that you figure he's got a little bit of is some power.
Absolutely, yeah.
Just a little bit.
Absolutely.
But Aaron Bolton doing everything right at the moment, staying heavy on top, just looking to try and chip away, really consolidate that position before perhaps looking to slip around to the back or posture up and land some ground and pound.
Yeah, Dan Cassell in his corner there, barking out some instructions just to maintain this position. He's doing a nice job there. It's hard to see, but with his right arm, he's controlling the right arm of
Lovely trying to Bolton there, kneeling, isolating that hand, going to open. If he can do something with that right arm, he's going to open the head up of Mildor, but again, this is smotheringly taking the round away, and it looked like Mildor was certainly in that opening minute very aggressive coming forward, and now Aaron Bolton has taken the fight and made it his.
Yeah, definitely. He's done a really good job of controlling, and now he's landing those left hands, which are very unpleasant.
Again, looking just to control, tie up Aaron Bolton a little bit, but Bolton in the top position and some chipping hammer fists there.
Yeah, thudding against the
absolutely, and ends it with a couple of body shots. And a great turnaround in the round for Intensity MMA's Aaron Bolton there.
Yeah, very good fight IQ as well from Aaron Bolton there. As we mentioned, he saw the explosiveness and he saw the power of Mildor coming towards him, who was overextending a little bit on those punches, and he level changed perfectly, turned the corner, got the fight to the mat, and then controlled the position from there on in. Did a beautiful job of controlling the position as well. A lot of that was to do with the wrist control. Constantly was maintaining the grip on the right hand of Fouad Mildor, and it makes it really difficult to get back up to your feet there if you're only using the equivalent of one arm. So you're using that arm to constantly defend the hammer fist, and you don't really think about getting back to your feet then.
Well, again, what Bolton did was take the fight where he needed to take it. It did seem that Fouad Mildor, his aggression, and he was throwing heavy, heavy leather to start that round. We'll see if he makes any adjustments. But Aaron Bolton, dealt with what he was given very well there. Touch gloves. Away we go. Again, Aaron Bolton, the red corner. The black trunks. Fouad Maldour.
Oh, Shama kicking away the leg there with that. Ooh. Spinning kick to the body and straight away again. Bolton looking for that level change. Just reaching in a little bit there, though, but
I think yeah, allowed Maldour just to land that one knee, but really chasing that double leg he's got. Nice, he had the end, then used the ankle pick, and we'll see if he can. Yeah, he's going to look to try and move on to the back.
This is horrible as well if you're Maldour, because you can tell that Maldour wants to engage in the stand-up.
Yeah.
He wants to throw those heavy fists of his, and when you've got somebody who's constantly looking for that takedown, grinding.
On his back, one hook in now.
Yeah, it's horrible, and beautiful work there from Bolton, looking for to just get that right arm underneath the...
And Maldour doing right, it needs to be the two-on-one, doesn't it?
Yeah, there you go. He's just going to peel it over his head and onto the other side of his head to just escape from this danger. There you go.
Maldour, though, unfortunately, he's going to have to put... As he's getting
it... He had this in position here. It's hard to see from where we are, but no.
No. But it does look like he might have to, jump from the frying pan into the fire just for a moment to be able to get back up. And now we got both hooks in for Bolton.
Yeah, and he's chipping away, and he's going to look to flatten out his opponent soon, and that's a horrible position to be in because... It's almost impossible to get back out of.
And Bolton now in no rush whatsoever. He just got to chip away. He's got to pick his shots. But what a dominant position.
Yeah, the referee's not going to stand you up.
Plenty of time left in the round as well.
You can just take your time and, like you say, chip away those shots and really
make
work for those positions that you want to get the fight into.
Make Maldour carry all that weight. Absolutely.
Yeah, sometimes when you're on the mat and your opponent's in a full guard position, you know that you have to keep working, otherwise you may get stood up, but in this position you're never going to get stood up. So you can just take all the time you want to work all those intricacies of the submission.
30 seconds left in the round, both hooks in. Is he going to try and roll Maldour onto the back? But
yeah, Maldour needs to escape from one of these hooks if he can, whether... Kicking the leg out there.
Just tried to flatten him out, as you called a little bit earlier, John. What a dominant round for Aaron Bolton. And again, not a whole lot of damage done, but plenty of control.
Yeah, absolutely. More, like we say, peppering shots, chipping away at Maldour than anything potentially fight-stopping, fight-ending, but...
But control.
Yeah.
Maldour was defensive for the majority of that round.
Yeah, definitely. We talk often on the commentary about the path of least resistance to get the victory, and we've seen Aaron Bolton has found that path here. It's to take Maldour down and control him, because when they get into that position, Maldour struggles to get back to his feet, and Bolton can just keep lying on top of him, peppering away.
Yep.
I mean, he's not really looking for those submissions too much either. He looks... A couple of times he looked like he wanted to try and cinch the forearm under the neck for a rear naked choke, but mainly he's just controlling the position.
Absolutely, controlling the position, making sure the fight takes place where he wants it to take place, and making Fouad Maldour have to do the work to change the position.
Yeah, definitely. And with a record of 0-2 for Aaron Bolton, he'll be desperate to get that win on his record. And maybe that's why we're not seeing him go for those submissions too much, because sometimes you can lose a position and then you end up back on the feet where you don't want to be. So perhaps that's why we've seen him a little bit more conservative with those submissions, but more happy to control.
That low kick landed from Bolton and elicited a great big smile from Maldour.
Nice little kick there as Maldour was making his way to his left-hand side. That right kick came up from Aaron Bolton.
Now Mildur's initiated this the clinch up against the cage, trying to throw some heavy knees into the thigh.
Yeah, they are. Nasty knees there.
But now it's...
Corner calling for the underhook of Aaron Bolton.
Yep. Oh, just tried to...
one or the other.
Tried to muscle his way around to the back there, did Maldour, but Bolton just
closing it up just in time. Oh,
that was a very, seemed like a very quick, I'm not sure. He's taking a point
holding the cage. There was a warning earlier. I didn't know what the warning was for, but it must have been for fingers in the cage. We don't argue with Paul Crossley.
No, definitely not.
And now Vlad Meldor has everything to do in this round.
Yeah, definitely. And he's certainly throwing with intention. I mean, every strike that he throws so far, I think he knows that he's going to be down on the judges' scorecard. So, I mean, he has to throw fight-ending punches, and certainly what he's doing.
Absolutely, sir. Everything quite heavy. Lots of looping punches. That last one came from last week. Oh, God. Nice knee to the body. And now Bolton gets that clinch. Pressing heavy. Trying to connect those hands behind the knees. Is he going for the...
Yeah, I think he's going to get it.
And he's going to try and put... Can't see if he's on the single or the double from here. He's trying to clasp those hands together for the double. He's going to pick that ankle. This is how he did it last time.
Yeah, Mildor needs to really spread that base of his.
But of course, as he's defending the takedown, he's not winning the fight. Trying to stay heavy. Trying to Donkey Kong away on the body there as well, Mildor. Aaron Bolton, though, staying sticky, really working hard to try. Now onto the back and takes his man down to the ground. One hook in, two hooks in.
Beautiful work there from Aaron Bolton. We saw Mildor just look for the switch momentarily. In the process, he gave up his back.
I hate that. It almost looked like he capitulated there. It almost looked like he'd just say, okay, I haven't got this. But Bolton now... on his way perhaps to a 10-9 round that will now be a 10-8 round because of the point deduction. And that could mean the difference for Aaron Bolton now. Moves to 1-2.
You'd certainly think so. And I mean, the look on his face is a look of relief as well.
Pork chop Dan Casale, happy with his young man. I'm just going to quickly have a word with the referee, see if it was for a second fence grab. Just one moment.
While we're waiting for the official announcement, a shout out to some of our sponsors here at GTFP, Supology, Keto Pro, Corrupt Sheriff.
Just had a word with Paul Crossley there. There was a number of warnings given to Vlad Meldor about toes in the cage.
Oh, okay.
And also he wouldn't be grabbing it, but he'd interlink his fingers into the cage and then pull closer in for the knees. And that's where the warnings came from, and Paul Crossley had seen enough. Well, let's turn this one over to our MC, and I'm going to predict now, because of that point deduction, there is no doubt Aaron Bolton gets the first win of his amateur career.
Absolutely.
For both of these fighters. After three rounds, a unanimous decision has been reached. To the winner, in the red corner,